numerical number 17. Here the mass of block is given as 200 kilogram. Is resting on a rough inclined plane of 30 degree inclination. Theta is given as 30 degree. If the coefficient of friction is 1 by root 3, then find the least and greatest forces acting parallel to the plane to keep the mass in equilibrium. That means mass is not moving. So let me explain the components and then I will explain the answer. You have to find the least forces and the greatest forces along the plane. So if this is the incline, this angle is 30 degree, a block is resting on the plane, its weight is acting downward, this angle will be 30 degree, whatever angle inclination make will be made by this. Also this component will be mg cos 30, this will be mg sin 30, friction will act in this direction, normal reaction is this. So you have to find the least force acting parallel to plane and greatest force acting parallel to plane. So parallel to plane means net force is acting along this. So the greatest force can be mg sin theta plus f when f is acting in this direction and object is moving in upward direction. Least force is mg sin theta minus f if block is sliding downward and object is moving upwards. So here you can see that n is equals to mg cos 30, which means f is equals to mu n. Mu is given. You can take mu mg cos 30 as force of friction. Now the least force. Least force when object is sliding down. That is parallel to plane. Least force parallel to plane. That is mg sin theta, that is 30, minus f. Mg sin 30 minus mu mg cos 30. Put the values 200 into 9.8 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by root 3 into 200 into 9.8 into root 3 by 2. So you can see that this is 980 minus 980, so that is 0 Newton. So the least force for maintaining the equilibrium while coming down, the force, least force parallel to plane is 0 Newton. This is the least force. Answer of the first part. Now you need to find greatest force. Greatest force, it will be when the object is moving in upward direction. So when the object is moving in upward direction, then net force, greatest force will be mg sin 30 plus f. That is mg sin 30 plus mu times mg cos 30. You know this is 980 plus 980, that is 1960 Newton. This is the greatest force parallel to plane. Now this is the last numerical of your book. if you find some numericals from other books, you can ask. Right now I am doing the application based skill questions, numerical application skills questions, numerical number 20. A body of mass 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram, 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilogram, is launched upon a rough inclined plane, making an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal. Obtain the coefficient of friction between the body and the plane if the time of ascent, ascent means going upward, time of ascent, let it be T1, is equals to half the time of descent, that is T2 is time of descent. Descent means coming down. This is given in the question. You have to find the coefficient of friction by this given part. So let me make a diagram. This is a horizontal. This is the height. This is the angle theta. This is the block. Mg is the component. Sorry, weight. This is again 30. This is Mg cos 30. This is normal reaction. This is Mg sin 30. And here you will get force of friction. Now for ascending, ascending means going upward. I have told you, while ascending, ascending means upward. Mg, it will, this is upwards. And this is downwards. Downwards acceleration is A2, upward acceleration is A1. Now Mg sine 30 plus F is equals to MA1. That is Mg by 2 plus mu mg cos 30 is equals to MA1. This is equation number 1. This is mg by 2 because sin 30 is half. While descending, that is downward, downward it will be mg sin 30 minus F is equals to MA2. So this is again mg by 2 mg by 2 minus mu mg cos 30 is equals to MA2. You can cancel the common part. This is equation number 2. Now dividing 1 by 2. 1 divided by 2. You are going to get g by 2 plus mu g root 3 by 2 अपॉन जी बाई टू माइनस न्यू जी रूट थ्री बाई टू एंड दिस विल बी ए वन बाई ए टू. फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन वी कैन फाइंड एक्सेलरेशन एंड देन न्यू. द लेंथ ऑफ इंक्लाइन लेट मी कंसिडर इट एज एस. सो बिकॉज डिस्टेंस फॉर डिसेंट एस इज इक्वल टू हाफ ए टू टी टू स्क्वायर बाई यूजिंग थर्ड इक्वेशन सॉरी सेकेंड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन एंड एस इज इक्वल टू हाफ ए वन टी वन स्क्वायर. नाउ ऑन कंपेयरिंग वी विल गेट हाफ ए वन टी वन स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू हाफ ए टू टी टू स्क्वायर. That is a1 upon a2 is equals to t2 square. So you will get it as this is the answer you need to find for Google form answer 1. Google form answer 1. This you need to find. I have mentioned the relation here. So you can find a1 by a2. Now put this a1 by a2. Put a1 by a2 in equation number 3. This equation. And you will get nu as. Solve this. This is for Google form answer 2. This you need to solve by yourself. So these two parts you will solve and fill in the Google form for physics attendance. Thank you for the day. You need to complete your numericals and notes of the friction chapter and send it to respective teachers' mail ID. Next, we will start with uniform circular motion in the next class. But before that, if you have any doubt in the numericals, please feel free to ask me. Thank you.